हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय लेक्चर। टुडेज लेक्चर, टुडेज सेशन इज अबाउट बेसिक मैथमेटिक्स पार्ट 15। इन 14 अ पार्ट व्हाट वी स्टडीड अबाउट द टाइप्स ऑफ ट्राइंगल्स एंड टाइप्स ऑफ क्वाड्रिलेटर एंड ऑल। सो टुडे वाइज ऑल द प्रॉपर्टीज वंस अगेन। सी शॉर्ट रिविजन, एंगल सम प्रॉपर्टी, what is angle sum property, sum of all angles of triangle is 180 degree. If you take this is the triangle, sum of all these angle, angle A, angle B plus angle C is equal to 180 degree. This is what angle sum property of triangle. Based on this we have to find out unknown angle. That's so we will take some example, then you will come to know that how to find that unknown angle. Okay, then exterior angle property. Exterior angle property. So what is this? This property is related to exterior angle. So if you consider a triangle here, this is exterior angle. You can take this is ABC triangle and this is D point. So here angle ACD is equal to angle A plus angle B. That means exterior angle of triangle is the sum of interior opposite angles. The sum of this triangle is equal to this angle. Okay, then isosceles triangle property. Isosceles triangle property means when two sides are equal in triangle, that is called isosceles triangle. Their opposite angles are also equal. Like you can take this is PQR triangle, right? Now ab ye triangle mein dekho, ye dono side equal diya hai. ये दोनों साइड इक्वल रहेगा तो ये दोनों का अपोजिट एंगल्स भी इक्वल रहेंगे। दैट मींस इन ट्राइंगल PQ इज इक्वल टू PR, देयरफॉर एंगल सी एंगल R अपोजिट साइड ऑफ PQ का अपोजिट एंगल, देखो ये साइड का ये है एंगल R इज इक्वल टू PR का, देखो PR का ये वाला एंगल Q, सो दीज टू एंगल्स आर इक्वल। दिस इज वॉट आइसोसेलेस ट्राइंगल प्रॉपर्टी। सिमिलरली इक्विलेटरल ट्राइंगल प्रॉपर्टी। इक्विलेटरल ट्राइंगल प्रॉपर्टी दैट मींस वी नो द डेफिनेशन ऑफ इक्विलेटरल ट्राइंगल, ऑल द साइड्स ऑफ ट्राइंगल आर इक्वल, ऑल द साइड्स आर इक्वल दैट मींस ऑल द एंगल्स आर आल्सो इक्वल, दैट मींस ईच एंगल इज 60 डिग्री, एंगल P इज इक्वल टू एंगल Q दैट इज इक्वल टू एंगल R दैट इज इक्वल टू 60 डिग्री। ओके, so based on these properties we have to solve the problems. So let me take one example. Based so example 1, find x in the following figure. So now I am giving the figure here, this is the figure. I will take L, M, N and this I will take x, this is 70 degree, this is 50 degree. Here we need to apply angle sum property of triangle. See, two angles are given, we need to find third angle. First find write down given values. Angle L is 70 degree, angle N 50 degree, so angle M is x, this is given. So by using this given, so apply angle sum property. So we know that angle sum property, sum of all angles of triangle, angle L plus angle M plus angle N is equal to 180 degree. So substitute the values, angle N is 70 degree plus angle M is x, angle N is 50 degree is equal to 180. Right now, so now 70 plus 50, here we cannot add with x because x is unknown. So that is variable, we have to find this value of x. 70 plus 50, what will happen? 7 plus 5, 12, that means 120. X plus 120 is equal to 180. Now x is equal to 180 minus 120. Then x is equal to 180 minus 120, 60 degree. X is 60 degree. I hope students you understood now. So now I will go for one more example. Let me take another example. Find x in the figure. So this is the figure here. And here we have to find the value of x. Here just observe this figure, this is exterior angle, right now? Exterior angle, these two are interior angles. So this is based on exterior angle property. Exterior angle property of triangle. So here we should know the exterior angle property. So exterior angle of triangle is equal to sum of two opposite interior angles. Sum of these two angles is equal to 100. So I can write here x plus 50 is equal to 100. You can write the reason here or else by property of exterior angle, or else you can write here also by property of exterior angle. You can write reason exterior angle property. Exterior angle property. Okay. So here this x is the unknown variable. Keep here as it is equal to 100 minus 50. So then x is equal to 100 minus 50, you will get 50. So this is the answer. 100 minus 50 is equal to 50. So x unknown value is 50. One more example. Example 3. Little bit complicated. Question is, find value of x and y. Find x and y. Here two unknowns are there. Find x and y. First of all, see, this is the line. Okay. Then these x and 50 are linear pair angles. See, this is also basic. You should understand this and you should know that x plus 50, these two are linear pair angles. Linear pair, sum of two angles always 180 degree. ये दोनों का सम करेंगे तो 180 आएगा. तो फर्स्ट बाय लीनियर पेयर x प्लस 50 इज इक्वल टू 180. देखो ये 180 कैसा आया, दोनों का सम 180, क्योंकि ये दोनों के क्या बोलेंगे, लीनियर पेयर एंगल्स, LPA, लीनियर पेयर एंगल्स. x प्लस 50 इज इक्वल टू 180 डिग्री. नाउ टेक दिस 50 दिस साइड, x इज इक्वल टू 180 माइनस 50. Then x is equal to 180 minus 50, 130 degree. So now you got x value. Now to find the y, again the same thing. Here what we have to apply? Exterior angle property. See, exterior angle property is what? Exterior angle is the sum of interior two opposite interior angles. So x is equal to y plus 70. X is equal to y plus 70. X value already we got. X value is 130. Substitute this 130. Then y is as it is unknown value. We need to find this y plus 70. Then take this 70 this side. 130 minus 70 is equal to y. Then 130 minus 70. What will happen? 60. Right now? Yes. Y is equal to 60 degree. You got x and y now. X is 130, y is 60 degree. I hope students you understood. Now I will give some homework to solve this type of problems. Thank you. Thank you everyone.
Students, these are the homework questions. See, question number 1. Find the value of the unknown exterior angle x in the following diagrams. So these are based on the exterior angle property. And question number 2. Total 9 questions are given here. In question number 2, find the value of unknown interior angles x in the following figures. So here you have to find interior angle by using exterior angle property also and angle sum property. Okay. So total in question number 2, total 9 questions are there. Students have to solve all the questions. Question number 9 is little bit tricky question. I hope students will solve this. If you not understood, so let me know, I will explain it. You just try that question number 8 and 9. Thank you.